Hi guys, I'm Arjun Menon. I'm a travel and automotive photographer. I'm stuck at home, like most of you guys. So today, I'm going to give you some tips on how you can execute shoots at home with the help of macro photography. But first, what is the definition of macro photography? Well, let's Google. Extreme close-up photography, wherein the size of the subject in the photograph is larger than its real-life size. So, backstory, back in March when I came back from some travel, I was quarantined at home. I thought I'll make use of my time and start a photography project. This time with my action figures, you know. So, what's special about this project? Well, I had access to only things at home. So, I decided to use household objects as my props and decided to create worlds that were indistinguishable. So, I ended up photographing one picture per week and these are the ones I came up with. So I'm going to give you some general tips about photographing action figures, but you can use this logic to photograph your favorite subjects as well. It could be scale models, it could be your favorite watch, it could be a human eye, it could be insects. The possibilities are endless. So here goes. Number one, conceptualize your photograph before you go out shooting. This means before you take out your camera and start shooting everything around you, come up with a concept. What does your photograph want to convey? Once you've nailed that, things become so much easier. In commercial photography, we use storyboards. Storyboards help you execute an idea really well. What you do is take a blank piece of paper, draw out what you want to photograph, exactly how you want to photograph, right? So it helps in storytelling. Like you place components in such a way that it conveys a story, and it also helps in composition. So you can add a dynamic angle that you want to photograph. So even before you start photographing, these things are clear in your head. So that's like 30% of your job already done. I personally love this process because it helps me fine tune the idea. And now I can look out for referencing. It could be in the form of posing, backdrops. It could be ideas of how to create a certain effect. All of these things fall into place very really well. The second tip I would really recommend is composition. Pay real attention to composition. When I'm photographing an action figure, one of the main priorities is for the scene to look realistic, right? So I want to photograph them in ways that a real person would photograph another person. Generally, if you photograph a subject eye level, they look their most natural and best. And this logic could be applied to various subjects like children, your pets, photographing insects, even action figures, right? So come to their eye level and they'll look more natural and it also adds character to them. So another tip within composition I would really recommend is using a tripod or figuring out a way how you can keep your camera still. Now what this does is it freezes your frame and now you have the flexibility to add, remove, or move things around to make your frame perfect. And so this really helps you up your game. What you can also use it for is layering. So you can add elements in the foreground and the background which give the photo depth. And that really helps you sell an environment. Three, my third tip would be props. When you're at home, you don't have access to all the things that you really, really want, right? So now, you have to make do with things that are available at home, for which You need to change the way you look at things. Now, when you're looking for props at home, you need to rethink how you're going to approach this. You need to break down designs very objectively and think how one object can look like something totally different with a particular angle or lighting and scale. So that is something that you need to train yourself, and it doesn't come overnight. You have to spend some time doing it. But once you start doing it, it's a process that you really enjoy.
I'm on the lookout for a prop that looks like a building. That. Yep. That might just work. You might just pass off as a skyscraper. And here we are. You look pretty decent here. Joker is doing fine. We have more props like keyboards and mixer juicers and ice trays, if you spot them. And with the right lighting and perspective, I feel we can pull off a lot of things as background props. Now, when you see the final product, can you even spot the AC cover or the ice trays?
Fourth, my fourth tip would be shooting deeper depth of field, which means more things in focus. Why? Now, this really helps out to put it in context with reality. When you're shooting a landscape, you don't particularly have one thing in focus, right? You have trees, you have mountains, you have a lot of these things in focus in one shot. And that effect you need to replicate when you're shooting miniature as well, so that it looks more natural to the eye. So when you're showing a landscape in miniature, you need to have more things in focus. Five. So my fifth tip would definitely be to practice. You're not gonna nail it the way you want it the first time you do it. And you're only gonna learn from these mistakes. And every time you do it, you're gonna get better and better and better. So give yourself that chance and practice. Six. One idea that people usually get wrong is that you need the best equipment to create the best images. And that's not really true. Especially with macro photography, you can get away with a lot of things with just applying your brain. Most of my light sources are usually torches that I use. The camera could be a phone or a small mirrorless camera. It does not matter too much. What matters is your concept. So that's why point number one is the most important point. I hope these tips were useful. Please reach out to me on Instagram if you have any further doubts. Thank you, Supari, so much for doing this. I really enjoyed this. Take care, guys. See you on the other side.